So in today's blog, we are going to discuss the right atrium quickly, right? So this is the heart in situ, and you can see the right border of the heart continuing with the left border of the heart. And this is the aorta, that is the ascending aorta. You can see very clearly, nicely. This is the empty space for the lungs, which have been removed. And this is the phrenic nerve, which you can see coming. So this is appendages, you can see. This is the right auricle, right? And this which is the appendage of the right atrium. So here we'll find the right atrium in the next view. These are the, you should follow the cursor here, right? These are the cut ends of the ribs which were cut to remove the lungs. So here it is the right view of the heart, and you can very clearly see where we have dissected the right atrium, from this to this. That is, this is the superior vena cava, and this is the opening in the central part of the tendon, that is IVC, right? So just to orient you, this is actually the dry part of the serous pericardium, fibrous pericardium, that was removed during the dissection, right? So this is the central part, central tendon of the diaphragm. This is the body of the diaphragm. Here you can see where I'm moving the cursor. So this is the lateral view of the heart in from the right side, and this is the dissected part which you are seeing, this from SVC to the IVC opening, right? You can see. Now here it is an opened view. Like, first I will direct to, yeah, now this is the most important part. This is the, actually the right atrium is divided into two parts, right? That is right atria proper and the smooth part. Actually this is carries the embryological importance. So it is the proper atrium part is has a rough surface, that is called muscular pectinity, right? So keep in mind that these are different from the trabeculase that you find in right ventricle. You can see it very clearly. These are the muscular pectinity, which actually they carry their name from the, you know, the teeth of the combs, from the names is derived from that, the muscular pectinity. Here you can see the clotted blood, right? So this is the internal view of the right atrium, and this is you can see the crista terminalis. It is a vertical ridge which is very clearly separating the rough part from the smooth part. So this all is smooth part. So this you can see the part of the SVC covering, right? And this is the most important structure in the right atrium, that is fossa valles. You can see the fibrous band very clearly, how it appears in situ, the dissected heart. It is actually, you can see the clotted blood around it, and it is the subsequent fate of the fossa valles, which is closed after the birth, right? So, and this is the there's ridge around it. So this is, this ridge you can see is the limbus ovalis, which encircles like a coma around it. So this is limbus ovalis, and this ridge continues inferiorly as the IVC valves, right? So this you can see in internal view of the heart. These are muscular pectinity. Clinical, if you say, if you want to know that, but during catheterization of the right heart, these are prone to get you know, damaged via catheter, right? So this is the rough part, muscular pectinity, and this is the smooth part, which is the rare bit of sinus venosus, which is, and this is the, this cursor part, the rough part is also called as sinus, right atria proper. And also you can see one opening, that is coronary sinus. Actually we have put cotton out here, so you can clearly see this opening. And the other openings in the right atrium are the superior, besides superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, anterior cardiac veins, venae cordis minimi, and this sometimes the right marginal vein also opens to it. So you have seen very clearly now the fossa valles, this rich crista terminalis, and this the opening of the coronary sinus, which is the major vein drainage of the heart. Now let us see tricuspid wall. In this picture you can clearly visualize the opening into the right ventricle from the right atria, the tricuspid wall. Now you can see the, you know, the chordate tendon also, these thin fibers which are projecting into the right ventricle. cavity, right? And these are the boundaries of the well, and this is the leaflet of the well. And also you can find a clinical aspect, that is, that might be there. You can see the vegetation around the margins of the wells, which are which may cause ventricular dysfunction, but this is not our today's topic. So you can see that valves also, the rough part was more sided to view this. So this is, again to orient you, this is the muscular pectinity, right? And this is muscular pectinity, and this is the valvular margins, right? And this you can see the coronary sinus. In this picture also you can see it very clearly. The leaflets are very clearly visible in this part, this leaflet, right? These are the chordate and any fibers, and this is the leaflet complete. So thank you for viewing this video. Goodbye.